Well, next to go, well, this young lady, she is one that the British hopes think a lot of for the future. Ros Canter with Zenshera. Ros, who comes here off the back of her best place finish. She was best place Brit at badminton just a week ago, finished fifth with All-Star B. Zenshera, certainly a very good horse for her. And he is one that has had a bit of time off. He spent a year on the sidelines, didn't compete in 2015, and then was just campaigned lightly by Ros in 2016. She was picked to go out to the plains in America for the Nations Cup team. This is the horse that she took there, and she certainly is very, very competitive at this level. She's a very smart jockey. She's only a little scrap of a thing. She's tiny, but she's very, very good, Jane.
This is one to watch for the future. This girl has got a lot of talent. She's very well known for producing good young horses and training them in the right way, helping them progress in the right way and come up through and develop into good performers. And this horse is an example of that. Lovely entry, very well balanced. Quite wide there. The angle, you're looking for about 30 degrees, and it's, some horses find their balance difficult to maintain if you go a little bit wider than that. But you need to have the inside hind legs stepping, the inside hind leg stepping under the body of the horse to help keep the balance and lift the forehand. We saw Nicola show that in a very good fashion. And the hind leg should step into the print. It will follow the path of the outside front leg in the shoulder in. That looked a little bit wide, but now we're into the extended. Good hold, good rein back, clear steps, positively forwards. Clear diagonal steps. The horse should move in a two-time beat backwards with the feet not dragging, not shuffling, not creeping, not showing any tightness through the back. That's nicely fluent.
What's their personal best at this level, Dan?
They're right on it right this moment. Ooh. 41.7, Nicole. Good timing.
Well, that was good timing.
That was actually with this horse, Zenshera, in Ballindenisk in Ireland back in 2014. Roz's record here at Chatsworth was actually All-Star B, is where she was with who she had her best score, 42.6. That was in 2015 here at Chatsworth. So. Anything below 42 is going to be in the PB territory for Ros at this level.
Ros is doing a very professional job here.
Well, 43.5 as things stand at the moment, Jane. She presents a really lovely picture, doesn't she?
She does, and the horse is very onside. Let's just see what happens with this. Lovely. Rosa. Lovely, soft and fluent, lack of no tension.
Well, things are really tightening up. The top 20 at the moment covered by just two show jumps. It's going to be exciting.
Sure is. Ros, obviously riding with a lot of confidence from last week, but if this, I mean, even if this isn't a PB, if this isn't sub 41.7, we just have to remember that it was, like, all the recent scores have been 50, 49 and 46, so, you know, it is still a very good test for this pair.
This horse very much on the comeback trail from having a significant time on the sidelines. And Ros really made a name for herself on Nations Cup teams. And then Zenshera went off injured. And she very much had a quieter year or so. All-Star B then came through to four-star level. And she's very much back with a bang now. And a really good team of horses, a professional team of horses. I know Sarah Charnley, her groom, who helps her at badminton last week, thinks a huge amount of Ros because she works exceptionally hard and she just puts her all into it, as do all of our riders.
A few nines creeping in now. This is going to help the score no end. There was a discrepancies with the flying with the first flying change. The judge at B gave a lower mark than the other two judges. Now, it's very difficult for that judge at B to see a clean change, but they can see the straightness. And so if the horse deviates, which the other two judges aren't aware of, deviates from the straight line at X.
Well, this could really challenge to be our new leader, because 40.1, I think they got the first nine that we've seen for a flying change. What a test from Ros Canter. And remember that name, because she is going to be on the scene for a very, very long time. And I have a feeling this is going to be a new leader.
Ros is just on a...
Confidence makes such a difference, doesn't it? And that was just a fantastic test.
She rode every inch of the test.
Well, breaking news, because Ros Canter has gone into the lead, 38.8. What a test from her with Zenshera. Dom, did you see that one coming?
No, I absolutely did not see that one coming. Their last three tests, 50, 49, 46. To go into the lead in an event rider master's class.
She rode that test every movement.
She was confident.
She was confident, exactly. And I think that's the X factor. We all know how difficult it is when you come into this arena and it's a tense atmosphere. It's an amphitheatre of tension. That if you've got any lack in self-confidence, it's going to show up, and that's going to be transported through to your horse. Ros came out here, she was on a high, and she rode every movement for a nine, and she achieved some of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But the lady that's in the lead, Ros Canter, is talking to Alice.
Yeah, and I spoke to you earlier, Ros, and we were talking about your fantastic badminton placing, and if case people have just joined us, the highest placed Brit last week at badminton, you said, yeah, that was my week, and we were like, I think this could be your year. Look what you've gone and done today.
Yes, I'm over the moon with my horse Zenshera. He's a bit of a family pet at home. He's definitely the yard favourite with all the girls, and he's like a little pony. But he finds atmospheres like this quite difficult. He gets quite nervous. He loves his horse friends, and he hates going into the arena on his own. So we're really proud of him today, because he just pulled it out of the bag.
He definitely pulled it out of the bag. Ros, if I wouldn't be so rude, you are pint size. He is pint size. Tell us a little bit about his background.
So when I was working for Judy Bradwell, I went to spend a week with Jan Graver in Holland at his stud, just to get some work experience. And I was put on Alfie, as he's called at home, every day, because I think they didn't really have another job for him, and I couldn't ruin him because he wasn't that good at a young age. And they'd actually had him in the carriage for, about 3 months, I think.
So he was a cart horse?
He was a cart horse, briefly, but he was a cart horse for about 3 months, because I think the hope was he was such a rubbish show jumper that he might be sold to America to do a driving job. And then I came along and I was gullible enough to buy him, so...
It's an extraordinary story, and look what he's gone and done here, leading the Event Rider Masters.
Oh, he's an absolutely wonderful horse. He wouldn't be the most naturally talented, but he has... you can't fault his heart. He would try all day long for you. He wouldn't be the world's best show jumper, but... He tries really hard, and if he pulls it out of the bag, he's normally pretty solid cross country. So,
and can you believe it, Ros, where you are at the moment? And you know, you've for a lot of people in the industry, you've been someone who's been impressing for many years, but you're now blasting yourself out there onto the world stage.
Yes, I think, it obviously takes quite a long time to get, you know, a string of horses up to this level, and mine are just coming through, but I think it's a confidence thing as well. I'm not the most confident, so I'm a big doubter of myself, but I've made a few tweaks over the winter, and it's really boosted me up, and I feel ready to show everyone what I'm made of.
Well, listen, we're loving watching it, and I'm sure this is only the beginning of an amazing journey. Listen, well done today.
Thank you very much.